Everywhere they are found, cranes hold a mythical, nearly sacred place in ancient legends, the birds of heaven. This may be due in part to the manner of their migration, easily reaching altitudes of a mile and more. They remain invisible to the human eye until they reach their destination and seem simply to descend from the heavens. Graceful, even elegant birds, cranes make their homes on nearly every continent, absent only in Antarctica and, mysteriously, South America. Whether individuals stepping cautiously across a wet meadow, or flocks filling the sky by the hundreds and thousands, cranes have a presence that draws attention. Tall, heavy-bodied birds with a long neck and long legs. Some species can reach 5 feet in height and a wingspan that can reach 6 feet. From its conspicuous red crown atop its head to drooping feathers, which appear to form a bustle around its back end, sandhill cranes carry themselves with a regal demeanor. For a month every March, more than three-quarters of migratory sandhill cranes, approximately 500,000 in number, leave their wintering grounds in Mexico and the southern United States to converge on a 75-mile stretch of the Platte River Basin in Nebraska. Here they rest and eat before pushing on to their summer breeding grounds in the northern United States, Canada, Alaska, and Siberia. These cranes will gain nearly 10% of their body weight while in Nebraska. Without the energy gained along the Platte, cranes might arrive at their breeding grounds in a weakened condition, where food may be limited until the growing season begins. Wetlands and meadows provide areas for rest, bathing, and courting. This congregation also gives gatherings of non-breeding juvenile cranes the chance to find mates. Although they reach sexual maturity at 2 years, juveniles often wait until their seventh year to court a mate. The day spent foraging for seeds and grains ends with a spectacle against the backdrop of the setting sun. Communal return to the safety of the river to roost. The Platte River here is very shallow, and sandbars dot the channels, providing ample areas to roost at night, giving protection from predators like coyotes. The ancient Romans believed that when roosting for the night, the siege of cranes will appoint one to stand guard while the others sleep. This lone sentry would then hold a stone in its claw, so if he fell asleep, the stone would drop and the splash would awaken the others. As they gather in the shallows in the waning light, a very clear pecking order is revealed of those who will pass the night standing on the sandbars and those who must pass the night wading in the shallow, cold water. Cranes are especially adapted to standing for hours in near-freezing water. They can reduce the amount of blood that must be warmed by constricting blood vessels in their feet. In addition, the arteries and vessels in their legs run next to each other, so the colder blood is warmed before it reaches the body. The month of feasting in Nebraska ends quickly. Their siege lifts, and these sandhill cranes will disappear into the greening north. Life for cranes can be more dangerous than one might imagine. As a conspicuously large ground-dwelling species, sandhill cranes must be vigilant, for the risk from predators is ever present. Foxes, coyotes, wolves, cougars, bobcats, and lynx all hunt them, given the opportunity. Actively brooding adults are more likely to react aggressively to potential threats. Spreading their wings while they hiss and kick, eventually they will resort to stabbing with the bill. Cranes of all ages are hunted by eagles, great horned owls, and, though much smaller, peregrine falcons. Courtship includes an elaborate dance, with birds spreading wings, bowing, tossing sticks, and leaping into the air while calling together. This unison calling strengthens the pair bonding experience. They throw their heads back and unleash a passionate duet, an extended litany of loud, rolling, trumpeting sounds. The mesmerizing courtship dances of these large birds has been the inspiration for Korean temple dances since the 5th century. In China, several styles of kung fu are derived from the crane's fluid movements. Sandhill cranes mate for life. When the pair reaches the northern breeding grounds, they mate and build a nest together, with each contributing to the construction among marshy vegetation in shallow water, though occasionally on dry ground. Established pairs return to the same nesting territories year after year, and sometimes use the same nest repeatedly. The female will usually lay 2 eggs. The chicks, called colts, hatch with their eyes open. Within 8 hours, they are able to feed themselves and can leave the nest. They are even capable of swimming. Flight will not begin for another 2 months. After leaving their parents, the yearlings gather into bachelor flocks with other juveniles and non-breeding adults. When cold winds begin to chill the northern breeding grounds, sandhill cranes will once again rise high into the heavens to begin their long journey across the continent, returning to their wintering grounds in the southern United States and Mexico. This is the first of 2 such journeys the newly fledged colts will make with their parents. Family groups remain together as an integral social unit until after the following spring migration. Juveniles must learn these migratory routes from adults. Without this modeling, they do not migrate. The species have survived since the Pliocene Epoch because of their complex social behaviors, long-term care of young, vigilance, and adaptability. Their ancient reputation as harbingers of long life, good fortune, harmony, and fidelity are well earned. they are indeed the birds of heaven.